Marbashi, welcome to Dubai. We're really excited to meet you today, and it's, I believe, your first time to be on an Arabic TV station?
Yes, and I'm so delighted to be with you and just like, you know, giving this interview. Yeah.
Thank you for having us. Again, this is not your first time in Dubai, right?
No.
So what brings you here this time?
Well, my brother also kind of, you know, he kind of stays here, and because of the Emirates Aviation University and the fact that Dubai loves Bollywood and most of the Bollywood actors, you know, we have a lot of work in here in Dubai, and I was here for the jewelry launch, and more of that, I finished two films.
فمن أجدد أعماله حالياً هو فيلم Black Rose وهو أول bilingual movie بيتصور بفترة كورونا، وهالفيلم من المفترض عرضه بشهر نوفمبر، والملفت فيه إنه هي الوحيدة اللي بتمثل بالفيلم ما في كاست معاها، اللي خبرتنا عن هالشي حصرياً.
Disclosing this for the very first time, the entire film has only one character throughout the film, and that's me. So this is something which is very unique, never done in Bollywood. It's just the entire film with just one single character named Vasudas. Also an added pressure because well, it's just you, so people might get bored while watching you in the film because it's just you throughout the film in like 2.5 hour film. So how is it gonna be?
What's your role exactly?
I mean, obviously I play an Indian girl, and it's a love story mixed with a thriller, and it's inspired by Shakespeare's Merchant of Venice, this film, the book Merchant of Venice. There's this character called Shylock. So my character Vasudha is inspired by Shylock. So she is Shylock in the film, and the character is super powerful, but at the same time she is lovable. She is very responsible towards her family, and I loved playing.
وحنشوف أرباشي معتمدة بالفيلم ساري أحمر ظهرت على البوستر الرسمي للفيلم فيه، وحيكون الأوتفيت الوحيد اللي حتلبسه بكل الفيلم. ومن أسبوع أطلقت الأغنية الخاصة بالفيلم اللي صارت محققة لليوم أكثر من مليون فيو على يوتيوب.
Saw you dancing.
In another bar, and it's a full on high octane dancing in it. And he's known for his brilliant choreography, so I was really delighted to be part of the song.
So again, you've also raised a lot of awareness during COVID-19 pandemic. You've raised money, so, and you started your own release fund. If you could tell us more about it.
I had my own foundation called Urvashi Rautela Foundation when I was in school. Always wanted to do some charity work and be a humanitarian, but at that time I had zero support from anyone. Obviously, I was a normal teenager girl trying to set up a foundation, do something for the poor children, or serve the, you know, humanity or serve the society.
ويمكن بوقتها ما لقيت دعم لتكبر الفاونديشن الخاصة فيها، بس هلأ بعد مرور سنوات وصلت لهدفها بمساعدة الناس المحتاجة، وخاصة من بعد ما تعاونت مع تيك توك للحصول على السبورت.
Yeah, I'd like to thank تيك توك because they wanted me for a special dance masterclass, and they promoted it really well, and through which I got around like more than 18 million people watching me, and it was a free dance masterclass which I did for COVID relief, and then we generated for about like 5 crore, which is like 50 million, and it was all given to the COVID-19 patients.
وغير هيك فيمكن البعض منكم ما بيعرف انه أرباشي فازت بلقب مس ديفا يونيفرس بالهند لعام 2015، ومثلت بلدها بمسابقة ملكة جمال الكون بذات العام، فهالشي بخليها تنضم للائحة ممثلات بوليوود اللي فازوا بألقاب ملكات الجمال.
I completely look up to Priyanka Chopra, Aishwarya Rai. Unfortunately, in my generation, we don't have too many beauty queens, and I'm the probably only one because
youngest.
Yeah, so my other actors like who work with me, my colleagues, they are I mean, they don't share the same kind of background like me.
وبختام الحديث حبيت أعرف رأيها عن هاشتاج بويكوت بوليوود اللي عم ينتشر حاليا ببوليوود.
Nowadays, like yesterday, like I go on Twitter sometimes. I see a lot of hashtags trending in India. And yesterday was boycott Bollywood. What's happening? Why is all of this happening? What's with the media lashing new news and rumors every day? What's your take on that?
Exactly. I do not know that why this happened. Hashtag boycott was happening, but I want to say that I can see like media also sometimes they just kind of publish the articles just for the heck of it, and I'm completely against it. I think news has to be verified.
In the Middle East, we like try to keep like updated with all the Bollywood news that's happening now, and it's so hard to follow because you know each hour comes up like something new.
It's just like playing with people's mind. And to all the Indians, I would say that the united we stand, that's the better, because I think India will be the superpower if every Indian is united and we all are standing all together, we unite ourselves, no one can beat India.